AR2 energy balls will stick to crane magnets. Grenades may stick or go through the magnet. If you stand on a headcrab and punt it with the gravity gun, its speed will be transferred into you. If it dies from being punted, the entire force of the punt will be transferred into you. Being bit by a poison headcrab temporarily takes you down to 1 health. If you're at full health, this attack deals 99 damage and pushes you back a really long ways. This is odd because any source of damage can be configured to not push you. For example, damage from fire will not push you. Some people have suggested that this is an intended thing to create distance between you and the headcrab. I don't believe this because there's too much inconsistency. You don't get this huge push if you're on the ground or you have low health. Most guns can be reloaded faster by first looking at a friendly NPC or going into any cutscene that automatically lowers your weapon. The gun will move up before reloading, and the game thinks this moving up animation is the reload animation. The actual reload animation will play after this, but you can fire during it. When stuff goes near these holes, they move weird. You can also break open these holes before the roller mines spawn. They have 10,000 health, so it takes a long time. These batteries will respawn if you throw them away. This one, though, doesn't come back. On this one level, crossbow shots can go through Alyx. This is to keep her from blocking your shots, since she's close to you for most of the level. Weapons and pickups can freeze crossbow bolts. Ammunition depleted. If you move the thing it got stuck on, it'll continue like nothing happened. Half-Life 2 physics are obviously not perfectly accurate to the real world, but there are some places where Valve straight up cheated physics in ways for various reasons. I will show many examples. When a vehicle is stuck upside down, it will usually flip itself over without any help. Ironically, in the cutscene at the start of Highway 17, the buggy is forced to flip upside down. Even though the buggy is clearly upright, you still have to exit and re-enter the vehicle for it to begin working. Crane magnets are configured to swing less than normal. These doors don't actually fall like this. The way the train sends you into the air is clearly fake. Many times in the game, an NPC's dead body is pushed a certain way for various reasons. Most of the time, it's just to look cool.